Kabarkova, distinguished delegates on the dais and off the dais, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here, and I would like to thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity to share views on the technology progress that is happening in the solar space. So I do have a presentation, if that can come on this screen as well, I'll appreciate that, so that the people on the dais can also view the presentation. So I'm with the GE Global Research Center in Bangalore. I've been there for about 15, this is my 15th year there, and drive a lot of research in the area of electrical systems, including power electronics, power systems, energy storage, controls, and this is for various applications across the board. And today I thought I would just give you a feel for what are the recent technology developments that are taking place in this solar space, in the industry, and as such by General Electric as well. So just from the role of GE in the solar space area, right? We play a role in multiple segments of the solar. So as the previous speakers had mentioned, right, when you're talking about a solar system, its module, its converters, it's the balance of plant, the controls, you know, all put together, right, as a solar system. Where GE plays a role is that, you know, we do not make modules today. We were doing that like maybe over 10 years back or something, but now we do not make modules. However, we do have technology. We develop technology for the modules, and I'll share more on that. And we have a tie-up with another company that actually makes these modules. In terms of converters, we do have an active business in converters, and the rest balance of plant, and also in energy storage as well. Now, in terms of module technologies, right? I mean, this is just to give you where we were back in 2009, in terms of the efficiencies of various modules and for various technologies. So there was a conventional silicon-based PV, the thin film-based PV, and then the multi-junction PV. So the challenge with the three, or the pros and cons of these three, were the multi-junction PV was very efficient but very expensive. The conventional silicon-based PV was somewhere in the middle, and thin film was very inefficient. And this was back in 2009. The advantage of thin film was basically that the manufacturing process was much easier and simpler than conventional-based silicon-based PV. So what we did was, we at the GE Global Research Center in our headquarters in the US, we pulled a team together and started to look at, you know, focusing on cadmium telluride, which is one of the thin film, you know, technologies, and started to develop that over the years. And subsequently, what ended up happening was, we had, I think 2 years back in August, we had a tie-up with First Solar, which is a cadmium telluride manufacturing company, where we are actually giving our technology to that particular company to make modules. And now, you know, First Solar is one of the major module companies in the world. And the recent announcement that just came early this year was that the efficiency of the thin films have gone up significantly due to all the research that has gone in. And today, they are as competitive as your silicon-based systems. Now, on the other hand, the manufacturing process of thin film is simpler, and so we do expect, you know, a lot of development in these type of thin film technologies as well. Now, when it comes to inverter, the standard inverter is primarily using IGBTs, which are power electronic devices, and the whole goal is to convert DC to AC, right? Which has been primarily in the industry. From an R&D perspective, we've been looking at silicon carbide devices. Now, silicon carbide devices as such are more expensive than IGBTs, but then they give, you know, higher energy capture, reduction in footprint, because you can run it at higher frequencies, and you can use less number of devices, thereby improving in reliability. Now, as the technology development took place in silicon carbide, we are getting into a state where, when you look at a complete system perspective, that is not just comparing IGBTs with the silicon carbide devices, but looking at the cooling systems and the balance that is required, you know, we are seeing that this has a potential, this can be a potential game changer going forward. And in fact, in just like this announcement came up like 2 days back in New York, they have a consortium, right, that basically is setting up a manufacturing facility in Utica for these type of power blocks. So this is silicon carbide devices to the power blocks and you know, getting into a system level as well. And this is something when we talk about Make in India and all, I think we should explore some consortiums like these with you know, the government in place to actually drive some of these development. Now, technology for grid compatibility, that's all with the balance of plant and all that. We look into coming up with basically either current source control or voltage source control. And primarily that is to reduce any fluctuations that you have, you know, when you connect to the grid. So you need to have appropriate controls in your converters to ensure that any fluctuations that you have can be meted out very well and that the oscillations are less. Now, when you take it slightly bigger, when we are not talking about rooftop solar and all that, right? Now, what happens when you all connect it to a distribution grid, right? There are two challenges. One is the power is going to flow on the other side as well, like from homes to the grid. So you have to adjust for the protection systems that are in there. Second, you also have to ensure that when a cloud passes over a solar system, you're going to see a sudden spike in the distribution system voltages. So you need to figure out how to mitigate those you know, voltage levels. And the more solar you have, the more impact that you might have on the spikes in your voltages. And so you need to develop appropriate controls to mitigate those type of challenges. And then you take it into a much bigger scale as well. You know, we all understand the challenges associated with the variability and uncertainty of renewable power, right? And we need to make sure the grid is capable of handling that. So we have come up with an energy storage technology that we can integrate with the wind to mitigate this variability. And we're also looking at hybrid systems, which is integrating wind and solar and diesel, right? And basically to, you know, kind of look at the summary of where things are headed. You know, the new technologies are emerging fast. The hybrid systems are coming in place as well, especially in India, in like as distributed power in rural areas and all that. And then to address the variability, you need to have appropriate you know, energy storage and controls, you know, to ensure that you're able, the grid is able to absorb this variability and uncertainty. Systems thinking will be the key, and we do need, I mean, from a Make in India perspective, I would strongly, you know, push for the need for local research and development within India to accelerate innovation. Thank you very much.